Good morning and welcome to STM's annual meeting on this, our 40th birthday. We're very pleased to see you all here. We share our birthday with a number of other interesting personalities, including today, Baroness Thatcher. I'm not entirely sure that's quite the company I want to keep, but there we are. We're very pleased that you can be here today. As you will notice if you've been looking at our website this morning, we've just published a new report, the STM report on STM, and this is something that we're going to be doing every 3 years, which will give an overview and an update of almost all the facts and figures that are known about our industry. And we've already had quite a lot of inquiries about this from the press this morning. Before we start with our main programme, I want to share something with you that we at STM are extremely proud of.
This is the Ogiek tribe in Kenya. It is endangered. This woman says they don't have a place to live or anything to eat anymore. All because the forest, their natural habitat, has been destroyed. The reason? Population growth and increased farming. The Mau Forest forms the upper catchment of the River Njoro, a lifeline for 300,000 people. It empties into Lake Nakuru, famous for its resident flamingos. This critical watershed is also under threat.
For the last like 5 years, Njoro River has not been flowing continuously over there. The lake has also been shrinking. Just the way you can see where we are standing, it used to be within the lake.
While more than a million flamingos settled on this lake as recently as 2004, today there are only 70,000 left, jeopardizing tourism in the region. But the biggest problems for local residents, the quality and quantity of the water. The Sustainable Management of Watersheds, or SUMAWA, is a research initiative aimed to improve the long-term health of the Njoro watershed.
From our research, we have found that this water is highly polluted. Its count, bacterial count, or coliform count, is well above what is recommended by WHO or anybody else. To give you an instance, the best coliform count we have ever had from our river is about 24, while good water should only have a count of zero coliform. But here, 24 is the best we have got, and we have gone as high as 100,000.
Collaboration between Kenyan and US universities, the Kenyan government, the UN Environment Programme and private sector provide support for programmes leading to affordable, real-life solutions. For example, at nearby Egerton University, the OARE Research4Life initiative allows students and staff free online access to over 7,500 peer-reviewed scientific journals, books and databases from over 130 publishers, including Elsevier, Springer Verlag, and Wiley Blackwell.
Online access to research on the environment, alongside with their sister partnerships on health and agriculture, really have overcome in one quantum leap a major disadvantage to many or most of the students in developing countries. They do not have the resources in universities and teaching institutions to subscribe to what are often quite expensive scientific journals.
As the Research4Life technology partner, Microsoft provides the platform for access and authentication, able to perform at the same level as today's most heavily trafficked websites.
Out of the research, I recommend that we need key interventions for reforestation in this area. That's a major thing we need to go into, and also try to rehabilitate some of the streams which run into Lake Nakuru.
Academics further developed a biosand filter, providing clean water for the first time. The health impact was tremendous.
pipes and filters have really assisted the community of Njoro. It is accessible to our people, and it has helped at least to reduce 50% of the people coming to the hospital. It has cut down the diarrheal diseases by around 20%.
Other Sumawa initiatives include tree nurseries and school greening programs. The endangered Ogiek tribe hopes to rehabilitate the Mau forest by planting 50,000 tree seedlings. And the children at Nudurugu Primary School are trained early on to protect their natural habitat.
Trees are important because they reduce soil erosion, they give us oxygen, and they bring rain.
In fact, they are taught a sense of belonging by planting the trees and calling them their own.
This project is very relevant because it has a direct impact on the farmer, direct impact on that individual person who lives in that watershed, that it is only if you take care of this environment by planting trees for your own firewood, by planting trees for your own houses, by taking care that whatever you put in the river is clean, take care of your environment, then everybody will benefit.
Although many challenges remain, public-private partnerships like Research4Life are effectively addressing real-world problems in Africa, providing innovative solutions to the people who need it most.
Ladies and gentlemen, this was made possible through the technical assistance of Microsoft, through the collaboration of your companies, and particularly two individuals I want to signal out: Maurice Long, who's been in charge of these programs for SDM for over 5 years, and Shira Tabachnikov at Elsevier, who was behind some of the video production issues here. And I think we owe them a debt of gratitude. So thank you to them.